Where is the final ballot box?
You are in charge. Is there a problem here with the voting? We're supposed to have the ballot box.
The seeds of change are coming. Byron Saxon here with the American Dream, and Dream tonight is election night.
Well, tonight we name a few general managers. Earlier in the day, we know we've seen some people running and hollering and screaming, and the ballot box had been not delivered or stolen. So there's some shady going on here, but we're going to crown a new general manager tonight. And Tyler Rex gets his opportunity to become Florida heavyweight champion when he faces Drew McIntyre. Big night. You look as clean as a Safeway chicken, Jackie.
Thank you. You ready?
I'm ready.
Let's do it. Yeah.
Introducing first, it is a tag team match scheduled for one fall. They are the current Florida tag team champions, Trent Beretta and Kaylin Brock.
Trent Beretta and Kaylin Croft, the reigning FCW Tag Team Champions, kicking things off this week on FCW. How about this combination, Dream?
Hey, what a way to start off FCW. Like you said, tonight, a general manager is crowned. What an election we had. 2 or 3 months went by here. I mean, a controversy already today in the office of Steve Kern. I mean, well, there was a lot of, there's some things going on here in Florida that's always kind of questioned me about the voting situation. But we're going to find out tonight.
Well, I think we all know who the right candidate is.
Well, I know you're biased, but we take a look right here. What an opportunity here. The Florida Tag Team Champions, Croft and Beretta. I mean, two of the top stars, really, anywhere in the world.
When we talk about Slater and Eric Escobar, this should be a great way to open up this election eve, if you will.
Election eve, you feel it?
I feel it, man.
You want to wear my hat?
Do you think they wrote my name in? Maybe I could be general manager? Did you ever think about that?
Well, it's crazy, Dream. Come on.
What do you mean crazy? I wouldn't let you go. You're my favorite person.
Oh, good, good. You're mine, too. We'll start things off there. Heath Slater with Kaylin Croft. To my knowledge, this is the first time that Heath Slater has actually teamed up with Eric Escobar here on FCW TV.
Yeah, and I tell you, it's a great opportunity here to give the kudos, if you will, to the president of FCW, Mr. Steve Kern, for putting this match together. It's starting off right here, man. And it is hot in Florida, but it's not hot or any hotter, if you will, as it is inside this building, because I talk about being on fire for FCW.
It is summer, it is exciting. The hottest ticket right now.
Oh, yeah.
Kaylin
yeah.
Croft maybe having second thoughts. Keep in mind, folks, this is a non-title match.
Is that true?
It is true, sir.
You know what? I got to test you sometimes.
I know my facts.
I was going to say that, but you got it written down there.
In my brain.
Good lockup right here. Collar and elbow into an arm drag. How did I call that? Let me show you how to do it. Collar and elbow into an arm drag. Backs off into the corner. What is that? A flipper in the head?
Oh, the harsh forearm there. West Virginia's. Oh!
Oh!
Trent Beretta nearly went flying over that top turnbuckle.
Oh, that's what I'm talking about.
Goes for the cover. Yeah, this is a non title match, but
you
again,
said that once. Let's say it again. Let's say it about 4 or 5 times.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a non-title match. However, keep in mind, Eric Escobar, Heath Slater, they come out victorious. Oh, here's the cover again. Two count. If Eric Escobar and Heath Slater walk out here with a win, common sense has got to tell you, hey, they move right into that number one contender system.
Well, I'll tell you about common sense. Common sense, too, when you talk about championships. I mean, I think tonight we are loaded for bear when we talk about Drew McIntyre.
Oh, no.
Title defense against Tyler Rex. And if you're anywhere in earshot or eye shot, you need to get by the TV.
A big main event still to come tonight as Heath Slater and Eric Escobar are working very well as a tag team.
What do you think when Fletcher Chase becomes general manager?
What, who?
Fletcher Chase.
I don't think about things like that. I believe that the best candidate is going to win, and the best candidate, in my own humble opinion, is Abraham Saddam Lawson.
Well, I'm going to tell you why. You were here earlier, too. And we went to Mr. Kern's office, and he never turned me away. You know what I mean? He said, yeah, come on in. But I could see that there was a bad mood going on in there, and there was something to do with the ballot box and the FCW, board of directors. They're going to make the final vote, the final count. They'll deliver it to Steve, and he should already have it from the way things are going.
You know what I always say?
What?
Controversy creates victory.
Well, thank you, Napoleon Bonaparte.
It's actually Byron Saxton.
Oh, here we go. Oh. I mean, nice move right there.
Yeah, right.
Hey, they're impressive. I'm going to tell you something about Crawford Barrett. They're impressive. They bring it.
Well, could be impressive for the win here. They go.
But don't you get the feeling that they can be beat at any time? Doesn't it seem like they're
going to win? If you look at their title reign, I mean, how did they originally win those tag titles? They had a handicap match.
Yeah, but they were the French man. They were the Brazilian man. They were the Indian man. They were the boys from Brazil. They were putting the band back together. They were everything trying to get it, and they finally got it. In a handicap match made by who? Made by who? Who made that handicap match? Yeah. Would it be Washington?
I don't recall. Well, you saw Heath Slater trying to desperately make the tag to Eric Escobar, but again, proving why they are the tag team champions. Trent Beretta knowing exactly where he was in that ring.
I'm going to tell you, hey, Byron, there are people standing everywhere in here. We got standing room only at 90-some degrees outside.
And they're still coming in.
We're in air condition. I just said that. If you will listen to me, I will give you education on color commentary.
Sorry. Fans firmly behind Heath Slater inside the FCW arena. Jeez.
Well, what a good matchup. This has been a great way to start off here. Look at this.
Look out. Oh, look at that slingshot double team over. Looking for that leg drop was Trent Beretta, but Heath Slater, knowing exactly where he was, rolling out of the way. And now, can he make the tag?
No, got the cutoff for me. That's good tag team action. That's good tag team wrestling. That's why they the Florida Tag Team Champion. Title held by me and Steve Kern. Me and numerous other guys, and I'm made famous by the famous Briscoe brothers. You know what I mean? When you talk about tag team championships in Florida history, and I know you study history.
All right, history. We got a Florida championship wrestling, and of course, a lot of these stars of the future. Oh!
Gotta make a tag, gotta get over.
Trent made the tag, the Caleb drop to
cut the ring off.
Cut the ring off just inches away from tagging in Eric Escobar, and just, oh. Not enough. Not enough.
You know who gave me this WWE Entertainment hat I got on?
What's that?
You know who gave me this hat?
Who?
Vince himself.
Are you kidding?
Yeah. Yeah. Woo. Took it out of his back pocket. See, people don't know that.
Oh.
He had it like baseball player in his back pocket. Just pull it out one night, give it to me.
You think he'd give me one?
Yeah, I know what he'd give you. And he had a hat. Here we go.
Oh, here we go. Eric Escobar finally get his chance. Back into this match. Oh, over Caleb Croft.
Has this FCW thing come together or what? You know what I'm talking about?
Absolutely coming together for Eric Escobar is hoping to lead his team to victory. Off the rope.
Got him right here. Got a big win.
Off the leg hook. Oh, no. Eric Escobar knows exactly what it takes to be a champion. He knows exactly what it takes to win. Former Florida heavyweight champion. Rolling here against Croft. Uh-oh.
Wow, what a pretty move.
Gotta put the heel, shoulders down. Trent Beretta tries to make the save.
Well, Eric Escobar is just a plane right away from being a superstar in the World Wrestling Entertainment universe.
Just like that, wow, Croft responded with that elbow. A two count, man.
Well, the redhead was in there, make that save.
Yeah, Heath Slater absolutely.
You only get
saved.
One of them before you're asked to leave the building.
And from behind, Heath Slater getting out of the ring. From behind, Trent Barreta comes charging in. And wait, Escobar maybe going for that Puerto Rican necktie.
Well, got sidetracked from that.
Oh, the numbers game. The numbers game.
Well, let me tell you what happened there, man. The number game, right. Eric's on fire. Watch out. What is this?
No. Barreta grabbed
the
foot.
He's got the foot.
Oh, man.
That ain't right.
Kalen Croft and Trent Barreta.
Just when you thought Eric Escobar had fended off both Trent Barreta and Kalen Croft. Numbers game, and I'll take a look. It was the numbers game that threw too much for Eric Escobar. Going for that suplex, Trent Barreta grounded the foot, and the tag team champions are victorious. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we've been talking about it, we'll continue to talk about it. It's election night,
and it's continuing on.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall.
Trent Sutton!
And it is his first from Las Vegas, Nevada, weighing 236 pounds, Dylan Fine.
Back here on FCW, and it is that man who calls himself the trend setter, the attention getter, and the one of a kind, Dylan Fine.
Dylan's been pretty impressive as of late, but my main man's coming out right now. I'm talking about if you got a Skittle, if you got like when the Skittle thing, and look at it, that's what you're going to see right now. A Skittle package. Uh-oh. You know what I'm talking about. I think I have a clue. Oh, yeah.
And his opponent from Puerto Rico weighing 350 pounds, Sweet Poppy Sanchez.
Ah.
¿Qué pasa, mi gente? Vamos a fiestar. Arriba, corazones. I have these candles for you, everybody. And for you, Valentine. This candy.
You're really loving this, Green. Oh, we'll try candy together.
I got some candy here. That's what I'm talking about right here. The most electrifying guy at FCW, man. When you go to the live events around at FCW and you see this guy get up an opportunity and the kids love him, the fans love him. I mean, it's a cool guy.
Well, just be careful, Green. I don't want you to get a sugar high here with all that candy, but Sweet Poppy Sanchez, accompanied by the Candy Girl, as we come to understand her. Go ahead. Hey, I think you're stealing some of your moves out there.
I tell you what, you got a little Foggy Like a Monkey in him there. I like that. You got some moves there. So we get down with this, man.
Oh,
standing back here. There's some people with no seats over here to come. Yeah, everywhere.
Man, don't let the dancing fool you, though. Sweet Poppy is one. Oh, offensively effective individual. Dylan Fine is finding out right now.
Yeah, he's strong, man. He's strong. Come out of Puerto Rico. Puerto Rico.
Right?
That said Puerto Rico.
Puerto Rico.
That's Texan for Puerto Rico.
I think that's the last thing on Dylan Klein's mind right now as he gets, oh, man.
Yeah, but Dylan Klein's made some headway, let me tell you. He's got a lot of people looking at him. I think the right moment, the right time, this would be it. If I'm going to beat somebody, it's on election night. Election night is on us. We get closer to naming the general manager.
Hey, Dream, who'd you vote for?
I didn't have no vote.
What?
I had a write-in vote. You know who I voted for, don't you? Well, who you said with?
Well, who'd you vote for?
I voted for myself.
Why?
Nah, I don't want to be general manager. I'm going to tell you who I voted for. I ain't going to tell you now. But I really think Fletcher Chase has a lot to say because of the network.
Oh, watch out.
He's more of a businessman, it looks like. Looks like he can run somebody's business. I know that you're Abraham Washington, supporter. So that's what makes politics great.
We respect each other, that's all. I respect his talents and his ability to lead a... lead a company like FCW.
Wow. Uh-oh. Yeah, you cannot. I got to say this. Either way it goes, it's an era of change coming at FCW.
A very unique forearm drop by Dylan Klein.
Did you hear what I said? It's an era of change.
It is an era of change. I agree with that wholeheartedly. And I can't wait. I've got so many plans.
Plans for what?
After they find out the results. It's going to be a big party tonight.
Is it really?
Where? Yeah.
Well, I can't. Fletcher's house.
I can't tell you.
I bet Fletcher wouldn't let you in.
What?
No, he would because he's going to need somebody like you. to keep everything straight when you're on the television. Whoa, buddy. Man. How about straightening that out?
Did you hear that?
Oh, Bionic Elbow almost. Little flip-flopping fly going down there. Not all the way. He'd have been down and out.
Dylan Klein. Figure out where he's at.
Big agility time for Big Papa Sancho.
It's going to heel kick Klein in the corner. Gets charged. Watch out. Oh, a boot to the face. And I think we know what's coming up next.
Here you go, buddy.
Up and down.
Got him hooked. Somebody call the law. They've been a mugging out here.
Well, he loves the candy.
Let me pop it go down.
He loves the dance. Down.
Yeah.
And he can add another W to his column. But, folks, the question is, later on tonight, can Tyler Rex add a W to his column as he challenges Drew McIntyre for the Florida Heavyweight Championship? Newcomer here at FCW, the first Austrian FCW.
Well, let me tell you about him. He's got his work cut out for him. But bottom line is, I watched him train, and he has a real big upside to this young man right here from Austria.
Man, he's about to face his corner, comes with quite a bit of fanfare himself. We heard from him last week, talked about his goals here in FCW, his goal to be the first FCW superstar to become WWE champion.
Yeah, impressive list of young men, and this is one of them. Had an opportunity, like you said, to take a real cool look at him. And two new guys against each other, trying to make a name for themselves, and don't get no better than FCW.
And I'm sure the nervous butterflies are a-flying.
The what?
Yeah, you like that? The nervous butterflies are a-flying. Get it?
No? Would it be like, yeah, you're right. On both of them. Yeah. On both of them. Yeah, I missed it for a minute.
That's what I meant.
Yeah, I got this combined.
Well, I can understand that selection, right?
I mean, well, I know, man. I'm telling you. Whoa, what a shot. Ouch.
Aiden Frost, I mean, this is a big guy. Not, you know, not to take anything away from Chris, but he's also...
Well, let me ask you a question. Nice move. And all of the live events where we had ballot boxes, they all came in, right? The ballot box actually in this arena earlier today was the one that, let me just bring it up to you, some hard time news here, was missed.
Watch out.
So the electro, if you will, the board of directors, we're waiting on that box to be delivered so they can count them and send the envelope and, you know, going from there. So hopefully that has been rectified. You know what I mean? Wow, that's a good move right there.
I'm not too concerned about that. Aiden Frost going for a shot there, reversed by Chris Raver, who drapes the back of that neck over the top rope.
That'll hurt you right there, too. Chris Raver, young man from Austria.
Raver says he's competed in over 24 different countries.
Oh, we got some good stuff coming on him. We went to Austria usually when somebody comes in brand new. We take a little close look. But we got another close personal look coming in the next few weeks with this young man, I'll tell you. But when we got ready to, Mr. Raver said, let's see about the nice matchups. He was the first in line, buddy. Didn't care.
Let's go. That's what you got to be here in FCW. You got to be hungry. You got to be looking for more competition. And certainly so. Both these men looking to better themselves and make it to the top.
Try to get him hooked up right there. Nice. Wow. That elbow stuck in there, man. That's almost like a cutting that artery off. You know the thing about your neck, what you call it?
Oh, yeah. That's a carotid artery.
Ooh. The crowded army. It used to be crowded when I was in it. It was so loud you could never do tonight.
Oh, good.
The crowded army. You're killing me.
Well, it's crowded here at the FCW arena. That's for sure.
You ain't going to be having no libations after this election.
Hey, don't you worry about me.
Oh, I'm just
excited. Oh, man, I'm excited about that. Chris Raber nearly took the head of Chris Raber.
Yeah, yeah. I'm going to tell you, man, the whole everyone is excited about who this new GM throwing him in right here. Ridden looks good. Both these guys look good. You know what I'm saying?
Aiden Frost, wait a minute. Hooked him up. He calls that the bell ringer.
He got him. Got him hooked up there.
And ring the bell for him. Aiden Frost, a very impressive debut here at FCW. And if you want competition, if you want something to look for, keep your eyes on him.
Wow.
And what? Wait a minute.
Right, hold on.
I understand there's something going on
in the back.
We'll get us there.
Huh? What the?
We have the results.
Looks like we have a new general manager. Excuse me.
Oh, my God!
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our FCW president, Steve Kern and Dawson Alexander.
Well, how about that scene in the back? How about that late arrival, from where the ballot box had been and the counts were in, but at least we got him in. Bottom line is, we're getting ready to name a new general manager.
All right. As president and CEO of Florida Championship Wrestling, I'm out here to announce the winner of the voting for the general manager for Florida Championship Wrestling. First of all, I'd like to take this opportunity as the president to thank everybody involved, all of you that voted on our live events and on the internet. Now, the new manager.
Move it, hurry up.
As a unanimous decision, our new Florida Championship General Manager is Abraham Washington.
Are we going to get a recount on this? I think this is Florida.
But what you said, Dad.
We did it. We did it.
Oh, man. Please set out. Well, congratulations. You've got his work cut out for him.
Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a glorious day. A glorious day in Florida Championship Wrestling.
Why don't you throw some confetti?
I wish I had confetti to throw. A brand new general manager, Abraham Saddam Washington. Sage has come, Dream.
Oh.
Sage has come.
Oh, believe.
Yes! Oh my God, this is surreal. This is surreal, dude. I can't believe this is happening. Oh gosh, I'm getting emotional. Oh wow, look at those moves.
Man.
Yo.
Boy, did you see the look on
Pleasure? You are the general manager, yes.
Did you see the look on Pleasure Chase's face?
Oh man, I don't even know where to begin. Hey, you can boo all you want. This ain't showtime at the Apollo. I ain't going nowhere.
Yeah, that's right.
No way, because now I am general manager of FCW.
Man, so
I'm a little choked up at the moment. Oh man, I think I'm gonna cry. And the first person I would like to thank is my mama. That's right, mama, I told you I was gonna do it. I told you I wasn't gonna work in that car wash forever. That's right. We shocked the world, baby, we shocked the world. Yes. And the second person I would like to thank, most important of all, is the big man upstairs. Yeah, that's right. The person without whom none of this would be possible,
my overweight landlord that lives two floors above me that tried to have me evicted. That's
what?
Right, I told you. You yeah. ain't getting your rent. So you and your lawyers can please stop calling me. I got caller ID.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And last but not least, the man I would like to thank, a man that truly put up a heck of a fight. Yeah, my competition and Bright House Network representative, a man of great intelligence, a man of great esteem, Fletcher Chase. Psych! I ain't thanking you, Fletch. This ain't about you, boy. This is about me. In your face, Fletch. In your face.
In your face.
I'm a winner, and you ain't
you need
nothing
to hold
but
it down.
A loser. Yeah, this mic ain't being shut off at all. That's right. So, to you, FCW, I want to make a promise as your new general manager that I will bring to you the greatest and best in upright and honest and fair sports entertainment.
That is beautiful.
Wow, man. I don't know. Hey, wait a minute. I know you're beside yourself. But
that is one of the greatest political speeches I've ever heard.
You've got to be kidding. That wasn't a political speech. That was an interview. He brought him out on an interview.
God bless you, Abraham Saddam.
We're going to find out what kind of GM he's going to make.
I'm so happy.
Hey.
Still to come, folks. Yeah. Still to come on this emotional night. Tyler Rex next will challenge Drew McIntyre for the Florida Heavyweight Championship.
Somebody bring me a hammer.
What a night.
Man.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it is for the Florida Heavyweight Championship.
Sunday, pop rocking, elbow dropping, SoCal dreadlock sensation, T-Rex. So put that in your bagpipes and blow as hard as you can, baby. Just a mess. FCW.
Well, I tell you what, this is a huge night for him, but I guarantee you, what a chance for if you're a fan to be sitting watching something special.
Today I decided to play a little game called How Fast Can I Go Before the Local Authorities Pull Me Over? Turns out 120 miles an hour was the lucky number before I saw the lights flashing in my rearview mirror and some copper tried to write me a ticket. My retaliation? I give more money he makes in a year and he ate the ticket.
Drew McIntyre is the prime example of a man who has been changed since winning that very championship.
Boy, he looks good. Both of them in great shape. What a matchup this will be right here at FCW. And might I add to you, match made by the one and only Steve Kern, president of FCW.
Introducing first, the challenger from Laguna Beach, California, weighing 252 pounds, Tyler Rex. Florida heavyweight champion from Ayr, Scotland, weighing 19 stone, Drew McIntyre.
Tony, the energy in this arena right now is amazing, Dream.
I tell you, a packed arena. Once again, hats off to President Steve Kern and FCW. And I might say, I just want to welcome the new general manager
you know, to the fold. I mean, you got to give it to him. With all the controversy, should I say controversy, well, surrounding the box that's in the arena here, to where the final count was made, or is it just
I don't think there's controversy at all.
Are you just there?
We have a brand new general manager of Florida Championship Wrestling, folks, and his name is Abraham Saddam Washington.
Yeah, and he says unanimous vote. I mean, what does that mean?
It means that all the most of the votes came for Abraham Saddam Washington.
I'll tell you what it means. It means shenanigans. You know what that word is? Take the word shenanigans. That's shenanigans. A guy gives me a dog and sells it to me as a good hunt dog, and the dog's blind. That's shenanigans.
Well, I don't believe that's part of my vocabulary. Right now, shenanigans.
Here we go, right here. No,
this
not
is what it's all about. The Florida Heavyweight Championship on the line. Tyler Rex going one-on-one with Drew McIntyre.
Yeah, let's get set in here. This is going to be good.
McIntyre, we talked about how much being champion has changed him. He changed his look, changed his intensity, changed his attitude.
Well, I tell you what, too, Byron, pound for pound, they're both about the same structure, if you will. Both of them train hard. One of them's from California and loves surfing. And Drew, obviously, as being champion, has let him live in a
life of the privilege.
Yes, a privilege. Yes, but he always did that, even before with champion.
But even more so now. I mean, having that championship around his waist is just taking him to a whole new level, both mentally as well as physically.
Well, when you go to the live events, whether it be Eustis, all these towns, and Bushnell, and you go all over, Florida, and you represent the Florida Heavyweight Champion that I held on 8 different occasions, by the way. I mean, it's a big deal. People recognize, hey, there's Drew McIntyre, the Florida Heavyweight Champion. I'm sure Tyler Rex would love for them to say, hey, that's Tyler Rex, the new Florida Heavyweight Champion. Could happen tonight. I mean, stranger things have happened, but none stranger than the voting deal that went down. I really believe that with Saddam Washington.
The bottom line is Abraham Saddam Washington is our new general manager.
Yes, he is. Yes,
no
he is.
Controversy.
Yes, he is. I didn't see that.
To speak of.
We'll see how it unfolds for him.
Well, Tyler Rex, I'll tell you what, you look at Tyler Rex in this matchup. Oh, look at the high cross body of Drew McIntyre. May win it here, no.
Wow, that was close. Tyler, that was good.
Yeah, Tyler Rex, you may look at him as a playoff basketball team or a playoff football team where he's had the opportunity before. He's had the chance before to unseat Drew McIntyre, a number of live events around the state of Florida.
Right.
Came so close.
Yeah, but take a deep breath. Bottom line, we're looking at game 7. Game 7, right here. On the air, we're watching it, we're seeing it transpire in front of us. We're seeing that. My doctor's here tonight.
It's almost all or nothing.
Did you hear me?
I heard you. Game 7, baby.
No, my doctor's here tonight.
Oh, your doctor's here tonight.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah.
Where is he?
He's sitting over there.
Oh. Well, everybody's here tonight.
Oh, I mean, I've seen celebrities from the Bucks. Even though some of them were in camp, they skipped out. I've seen some great baseball players in here. Some of the legends are in here. And there have been some legends from the world of sports entertainment, WWE. Yeah, do you ever go to WWE.com?
All the time. Oh, watch out. McIntyre to the outside. Showing just how important it is.
But it's not as good as FCW.com. You know what I'm talking about?
Oh, of course.
Well, it might be, but
we're about the same level.
Well, he rocked him out there, and he's doing a good thing. I talk about Tyler Rex doing a good thing, opportunity, not rushing out, making a mistake, lean over, make a mistake. You see what goes down. You see what goes down.
McIntyre has a hook in a very precarious position.
Wow.
Scrapes his neck over that steel railing on the outside. My gosh, both men down. Florida Heavyweight Championship on the line. Which man's going to walk out victorious? Back here on FCW TV, if you're just joining us, Drew McIntyre defending the Florida Heavyweight Championship against Tyler Rex. This is our main event. And just before the break, Drew McIntyre changing the tide in his favor, draping the neck of Tyler Rex over the steel railing, and now capitalizing on that.
Everyone knows when you're the Florida Heavyweight Champion, you not only walk around with a bullseye on your chest, but you raise a lot of eyebrows, not just here in FCW, but as well as World Wrestling Entertainment. And that's why the hunger's there. Watch out from behind, rolls him up now.
Look for the high risk maneuver, a little drop kick right there, rolled out of the way, went a little drop kick, got one right behind his head. That will hurt for a long, long time.
new general manager. I hope he's watching.
I'm
Steve
sure
Kerr
he is.
Put this match together. So I hope he's watching and learning as we go. I'm sure he's going to do his own thing. I'm anxious to see what that is. I can't wait till next week, but I can't wait till this game seven here is finished and to see who's crowned the new Florida Heavyweight Champion. I said a mouthful there, but it was good.
It was good, but what isn't good is what's happening to Tyler Rex right now as McIntyre.
What isn't good is them red gloves on your
arm. Man. Ooh. Yeah, I like it too. McIntyre continuing to maintain the strategy of attacking that neck of Tyler Rex, hooking the leg.
Yeah, I agree with you right there. I think there's some there's a momentum problem with Tyler Rex right now. And the momentum has switched over into the camp of the Florida Heavyweight Champion, Mr. Drew McIntyre.
We've had the opportunity over the last year to see the maturation of Tyler Rex.
The what?
The maturation of Tyler Rex.
Man, I mean, I could, you know, you can just zoom one over my head every once in a while like a fastball. I wouldn't know maturation from I ain't gonna say it, but another word that rhymes with it.
We've seen the growth. Put it that way.
Well, why don't you just say that? Because all my fans out there, my truck drivers and everyone, and my lawyers, they don't know them big words. My attorneys don't even know them big words, especially my attorney, Willie Cheatham and Howe. But anyway,
watch out.
I think Willie Cheatham and Howe might have been messed up in that ballot box thing. Well, what a matchup we got getting here.
No controversy there. But as we said, we've seen the development of Tyler Rex over a great deal of time here on FCW TV, former tag team champion.
Well, we've seen his maturation come through. You know what I'm talking about?
Is that good? Did you just say that?
Yeah, thank you very much.
Unbelievable.
You've been a beautiful audience. Elvis is up the building.
It never ceased to surprise me. But Tyler Rex, nonetheless, working his way up the ranks of FCW and tag team division, held those tag titles, now has turned his focus to becoming the top dog, if you will, in Florida Championship Wrestling, and he can do that tonight if he can defeat the other man in that ring, being Drew McIntyre.
Oh! You're not going to get it done like that going for a cover.
Not
could
at
be
all. Walking into that, boom, Drew goes for the cover, and you can see the sort of the frustration, yet mixing with the intensity, building with the champion. Stomping away on Tyler Rex.
Wow. He's got the right direction. Drew McIntyre is headed in the right direction. If you big star bound, it's a long, hard ride. But it looks like he's in for the count.
Oh, draping that neck.
And you know what I heard? They were going to put a fourth desk out there, the big pay-per-view, where they put ECW, SmackDown, Raw, and over the end, they're going to put a little desk for me and you, FCW, just in case you want to call for that. Is that cool?
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, that'd be great.
That'd be great. But I don't know now with the new general manager, we'll be able to pull it off.
Watch out. I'm sure things will be tremendous. I'm sure we'll continue to see great action-packed matches like we are right now between Drew McIntyre, the champion, and Tyler Rex.
Not step on you. This is the best, though. This is why we come. This is why you come to the game. This is why you spend the money, bring the kids, come to the game.
Every eye in this arena is centered on the squared circle, centered on those two men, knowing that they are seeing two of the best in FCW today.
Boy, took a hard hammer behind. He's really worked on that back since intermission. I'm not intermission, but we went to a break. We come back. Intermission is when you go get hot dogs. But, wow.
I'm sure the back, lower neck, Drew McIntyre. Showing why he's a champion. He picked the body part, picked an area.
Whoa, brother, he unloaded on him.
And out of the blue, Tyler Rex responding with that drop kick. McIntyre bouncing off the turnbuckle. Now he's in trouble.
Would you call that a missile? That ain't like from the top. That's a standing missile drop kick right there.
Standing missile drop kick.
Brother, if the turnbuckle had been there, he would have flew out into the audience. I guarantee it.
Drew McIntyre, literally did not see that coming at all.
All right. See, we change that momentum right here, Mr. Tyler Rex.
He's got to capitalize. He has to be able to capitalize now. No, it's all on the line.
Big elbow.
Charging in, back body drop by Tyler Rex.
Got that momentum headed his way. Byron.
Rex feeling it deep down in his soul, feeling that he could just be moments away from finally defeating Drew McIntyre. McIntyre tried to reverse, gets that hit to the gut. And I think we are just moments away from seeing Tyler Rex. And his...
Yeah, well, don't count your chickens before they have.
High tide. Oh!
count them and they deliver.
Get him hooked up.
Hooks the leg. This could be no.
See what I'm saying?
No.
See what I'm saying? Too much fight. Too much fight left in the Kemba of Drew McIntyre.
What is it going to take for Tyler Rex to defeat Drew McIntyre?
Man, if you're watching this at home, you need to call somebody.
Rex.
I mean, you know, Sunday night, you need to get him over there. We'll be taking a look at this. High-risk maneuver here.
Yeah,
this could work against him, Byron.
He's got to hurry up. McIntyre is getting back to his feet. Tyler Rex, oh, took a little too long on that top rope and was draped by Drew McIntyre. McIntyre still favoring that lower back. That lower back, but having enough wherewithal to catch Tyler Rex, and maybe now, uh-oh. Going for a superplex, it looks like. Rex trying to fight him off. Both men jockeying for position.
Yeah,
this is a very dangerous place to be.
Yeah, no man's land.
Watch out! Oh,
that's
man.
It. You can call this one over.
Oh, my.
You go ahead and call this one over.
Gosh.
I'll tell you what, though. You know who took the brunt of that, too, was Drew McIntyre.
I believe, I don't know, man. It's hard to tell. Both men are out. McIntyre showing a little bit more movement, but that's not saying
he's
a whole
him.
Lot.
He's got him. It's done.
It's a cover.
Wow. Is this a match or what here at FCW, the FCW Arena?
The shoulder of Tyler Rex, perhaps on instinct alone. Trying to pull himself back to his feet. Trying to will himself to victory in this match. McIntyre continuing the onslaught. Boot to the face. Rex's response. Powers up, hooks the leg, shoulders down in the middle of the
Whoa,
ring.
Buddy. Somebody call somebody. Whoa. How close was that? How close?
That's about as close as you can
I
get.
I mean, we're in overtime here at Game 7. You know what I'm saying? We're in overtime.
It's heart. That's all it is. It's heart right now, Dream. Who's got the biggest heart? Who wants it more?
Once again,
Rex
looking for height.
Uh-oh.
Does not work.
Watch out. Oh, my God. McIntyre
Showtime.
Caught him with that power bomb.
That's it. That's
this
it.
Is sound.
Oh, man. They are standing in the arena. They
Tyler
are standing.
Rex.
That's all I can say.
Tyler Rex will not give up. Will not give up.
Now, what a matchup. I am so proud. Oh, buddy.
Double boot to the face.
Trying to go up top. Here we go.
Going up to the side. He connects. He connects. Shoulders down. He's got the legs hooked up.
Oh, buddy. Wow.
Unbelievable.
Wow. I am exhausted watching this matchup. It don't get no better than this. I don't care what level you're on. Period.
Tyler Rex and Drew McIntyre are stepping it up in every way possible. Now Rex going for that burning hammer. McIntyre trying to reverse, going for that Scott drop now. Each man knowing the other's intentions.
Trying to get him up. Back behind him, Mr. Scott drop. Oh, caught the ref.
Oh.
Oh, buddy. I like it. I like it. I like it.
The referee has been knocked out by the boot of Drew McIntyre.
Got him hooked. Give me a
Tyler
count.
Rex.
Give me a count.
Tyler Rex has the championship, but there's no one to make the count. Referee has been knocked out.
This is chaos. This is chaos.
Tyler Rex trying to revive the referee. McIntyre back up to his feet.
God
drop. Drop.
That's it, buddy. That's it.
The referee rolling over.
Wow.
My God.
Man, I mean, amazing, amazing.
What is it going to take? That's the question Drew McIntyre is asking himself right now.
Yeah.
What does he have to do to retain his championship?
I'll tell you what, just give me cold chill. Got him hooked up in a small package.
Small package!
Got two. He got two. I mean, was that close? How close was that?
Goodness gracious. Drew McIntyre somehow got his shoulder up.
And it discombobulated Drew. You know what I'm saying?
He's got to
stay on. He's got it up, yeah.
He's got to stay on target. Rex.
Slip behind.
Agility reverses that Haslam for the burning hammer again. McIntyre this time. He
got
connects.
Him down.
He's in the center of the ring. He's bent.
He got it.
He got it.
Wow.
My God.
Rollins has defeated Drew McIntyre to become the new Florida Heavyweight Champion.
Unbelievable. Wow. Take a look at this amazing action.
It was back and forth, Drew. We didn't know which way it was going to go. You thought Drew McIntyre had the advantage. Hit him with the Scott drop. Referee made the count. Rex still managed to come back and hit him with the burning hammer to win the Florida Heavyweight Championship.
Wow. Wow, what a night we've had. What a night we've had. Wait a minute.
That's Joe Henning.
It's Joe Henning.
That's a former Florida Heavyweight Champion, Joe Henning. We haven't seen Joe in months.
Joe Henning picked an opportune time to come back. Hats off to Steve Kern. What a matchup. The best matchup, period, at FCW in 40 outings. Unbelievable.
I'm curious
Look at
to see
this.
What's going to happen.
Tell you what.
And how about that?
Welcome back. Wow. Unbelievable.
Provided the endorsement for the new Florida Heavyweight Champion, Tyler Rex. Ladies and gentlemen, man proving that dreams can come true if you work hard and dedicate yourself.
New
and
champion.
We now have
new champion, new GM. I can't wait to next week, buddy.
For Byron Saxton and the American Dream, we'll see you next week.
And until next week, adios, arrivederci, so long from the Sunshine State.